Oh, this is really good.
I'm a big fan of sweet soy sauce and a big fan of steaks. That's why I want to test if we can make these two ingredients work together. Today is the day that we're going to find out if it's a good idea to marinate your steak in ketchup mayonnaise. For today's experiment, I selected two beautiful steaks, 100 days grain fed, a lot of intramuscular fat, which means juicy, flavorful steaks. And this is the black gold of ingredients, a delicious, flavorful, ancient sauce, fermented from the best soybeans you've ever seen, mixed with beautiful spices. It's rich in flavor and it can boost any sauce and make anything taste better. Sweet soy sauce is the base of this marinade. Sweet soy sauce is the same as ketchup mayonnaise, or otherwise known as ketchup mayonnaise. We're using a lot of it for our marinade. This is 2 liters of ketchup mayonnaise. Excellent stuff. It's got a lot of salt and a lot of sugar in it, and that's why it's the perfect base ingredient for a marinade. Of course, we're gonna boost the flavors of this marinade even more. I want it to be the best it can be. So we're going to start with 1 lime that we're going to quarter, a whole red chili pepper cut into parts, 1 shallot that I'm going to peel, a large chunk of ginger sliced up. Of course, we also need to have garlic, which I'm going to peel. I'm adding all of these ingredients to our black gold. The shallot is a little bit large. I'm cutting it in half. Now, where's that last piece of red pepper? I know it's somewhere. Ah, found it. Here's a little know-how. There are 2 reasons why you need to marinate your steak. 1, marinating to make it more tender. 2, marinating to add flavor. If you're marinating to make it more tender, you would add enzymes. Enzymes from a kiwi, from a pineapple, and it will break down the structure in your steak and make it much more tender than it's been before. What we are doing is marinating for flavor. We're adding salt and sugar, which is in our ketchup mayonnaise, and all of these spices that are in there are going in with the salt and sugar and make it taste even better. A steak like this needs at least 6 hours of marinating time. So let's set it in the marinade and pop it in the fridge. All right, let's fire up the barbecue. While we wait for our barbecue to come up to temperature, we're going to rinse off our steak with cold water. I want to make sure that I get as much ketchup mayonnaise or sweet soy sauce off as possible. It's packed full of sugar, and if I leave it on, it's just gonna burn. Now let's pat it dry. Both steaks are fantastic steaks with a lot of intramuscular fat, a nice fat cap on top. They're both gonna be absolutely fantastic. You can clearly see that the steak that we marinated is kind of like disintegrated. It's almost falling apart and just barely holding on. But the color looks really good. We definitely added a lot of flavor. Now it's time to grill. I've cooked both steaks the same way, reverse sear. I let them come up to temperature slowly, and once they reach the 52 degrees Celsius, I put them on that sizzle zone. Getting those nice hot flames onto our steak and building up that crust. Look at how they turned out. Absolutely fantastic. Steak, ketchup mayonnaise, bringing these two awesome ingredients together and then having them marriage in one dish. And if I take a look at it, I can already see the difference. The ketchup mayonnaise steak, it has a beautiful crust on the outside with a lot of Maillard effect and even a little bit of char because all of that sugar on the outside. With our Reverend steak, it just looks like a fantastic steak. Well, you guys saw the steak, it's fantastic. It has intermuscular fat, it has a lot of fat on the outside, which means a lot of flavor. The beautiful bone to chew on. What more could you wish for, right? So without further ado, it's time for our taste test. Are you ready, Morsen?
Oh yeah.
Let's roll it.
Which one first?
Reference steak.
Juicy. What kind of steak was it again?
Oh, come on. Fantastic steak.
Okay, Black Angus. Can I have another piece? This small piece?
Nope.
A lot of fat.
Okay, as a reference, it's a really good steak.
I love these steaks. They're not the most expensive steaks. They are affordable still a little bit. And they taste amazing. It's tender, it's juicy, it has flavors. Absolutely fantastic. And I'm just afraid that we ruined it with ketchup mayonnaise.
Now the ketchup steak, it looks different from the inside.
Oh,
this is really good. This is really, really good. I want to eat this tiny little piece because I think this is the good stuff.
Cool.
Seriously, this is almost like bacon. Like the ketchup bacon that you made. Oh, and the fat.
I want to get me the crust.
The fat is like bacon.
I love it. I love it. What you said is like a mix between bacon and satay, and then beef satay. It also changes the texture of the beef.
Okay, if you don't eat a lot of steak, don't do it. But if you already know the taste of a good steak, do this. Recreate this.
So here's the million dollar question, Morsen. Better than mayonnaise steak or not?
It's really, really close.
I like how the flavor penetrated into the meat here. And you don't get that with putting mayonnaise on your steak. Even though it creates a... No way. What if we put mayonnaise on this steak and grill it? I'm saving that one for a later video. Woo! I said it first. I got dips. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, and you know the drill, leave us a big thumbs up and a comment down below. A big thank you to all of our patrons. Without you, we couldn't do it. So, hope you guys keep on watching our videos, and you might have heard about it already, but we got a podcast going. So check that out. Look on Fired Up. It's on YouTube as well. Fired Up, the barbecue podcast with Chef Eric and me. So definitely check that out. See you guys next time. Until then, eat smakelijk and...
Keep on grilling.
With ketchup and mayonnaise. Woohoo! I love this morsel. This is good. You want a bit more?
Yeah.
There you go, man. Mm-hmm. No, I love that crust. I think the crust is really... It's sweet steak now, but it really sells it. And I think it doesn't take away from the expensive steak. It doesn't make it bad.
What if we would do this with Wagyu?
You think we can do it?